Culture and Heritage. I'm going to talk about a land where you can find many and multiple things. This land offers not only the scenic beauty, the peaks, the mountain ranges, but also 5,000 years old history. This is the land where we can see this rock inscription. In this image, we can see the whole history. The history of the first millennium BCE. And this is in this land. We can also see these rock paintings which narrate every image of this rock painting narrates a complete story. Don't see it that these are just small images, but this is every image. There is a social life, there is an agricultural life, there is an economical life. If you see, get close and explore each and every image of it, you will go into the past, a chapter in the history. So this is land where Alexander came and fought and went. And this is the land where Ashoka ruled. And this is the land where the second Buddha, Guru Rinpoche, or Padmasambhava, born. So this is the land where Bazira, the city of Alexander, exists. And this is the land where you can see more than 200 rock carved statues of Buddha and Bodhisattva, Maitreya and other deities. So this is the land where you can see the architecture stupas of the Buddhist time of Gandhara era. It's another glimpse of a stupa from above. And this is another glimpse. And this is the land where you can explore and you can see castles of the past. This is Rajgiri, locally known as Rajagira. Another glimpse. And this is the land where we can trace the early traces of Islam. And this is Mahmud Ghazni Mosque. So, this is the land which is an open museum, which is an open art gallery, where you can explore and see art and culture, heritage and civilizations, artifacts and monuments. And story does not end here. This is the land where there are mountains, Elam, Mankhya. I must mention it that this peak is mentioned in the 2000 years back in the sacred books of Buddhism, that this is a sacred peak for Buddhists. And we have Myagrasa. And this is the land we have Phalaksa. So, in these mountains, we have opportunities for trekking. And, of course, this is the land where you can find steep rocks and opportunities for rock climbing. So, this is the land where you see waterfalls, pastures, Royal Gardens. Legs. This is Dudar leg. This is Kool leg. Some people call it Andhra leg. So this is the land known as Swat, the ancient Udyan, which is the land of scenic beauty and cultural heritage. But what we don't have it here. We don't have proper tracking tourist information centers. We don't have maps, proper tracks and trails, which I have found it in the other world, in the international world. We don't have that much tracking facilities, signs. We don't have trackings here. We don't have networking. Now, SPS and SWAT trackers are going to do such kind of, to arrange such useful types of meetups here. The tourist corporation, they should develop some of the tracks for common people. Because to this side, I can see a lot of professional people. But a lot of common people, they can't do that 7,000 and above. But they want to explore these lower peaks. They want to go there. So the government can develop tracks